playing and they used to turn the lights out in our meeting room and run through a situation like this and say, just think about what it would be like to be up on the road and take the crowd out of it.
Gone,
maybe
gone,
they did some of that.
Gone.
From the end zone, here's Darnold. And that will be incomplete. They couldn't hook up on what's going to be the final play of this first quarter. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10.
Four down. Check.
All right, now, lucky 56.
Watch Mike.
They'll throw again from their own end zone. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
So the yellow flag came out, and that leads to a new set of downs for this offense, first and 10. After the penalty, it's Crowell. And he'll take this one up over the 20 to the 21-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down, a very solid gain on that play.
Second down, Darnold. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 22. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And down he goes just shy of the 25. Now a penalty marker is down. Let's see what that's about. Darnold going to lead the Jets up now, first and 10 at their own 11. Here's again to Crowell. And he takes this across the 15 to the 17. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to second and 4.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
Second down. And Davis has it over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets this football out shy of the 30 to the 29. 12 yards there as they keep this drive rolling. It's another first down. Crowell. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play there. Second down.
All runners count on their eyes to find the gaps and creases, to find open space. There was absolutely none on that one. Totally swallowed up on that play.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down.
Detroit! Watch it now, Barney!
Darnold from the gun. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
They come up to the line now facing a third and 10 after the incompletion.
Tight end right. All right, now, Lucky 56.
Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. Got his man, Isaiah Crowell. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down.
So much about offense is what you call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job there of limiting that and keeping him from a first down.
Yeah, stopped him in his tracks. Try and start this drive in the air. And Stills over the middle. And he's able to get this one all the way past the 30. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Well, as this game continues to evolve in the NFL, you know how much coaches love run after catch. But you know what they love even more? Completions.
Yeah, just holding on to the ball.
Catch it, cover it, tuck it away. Whatever you get after that is almost gravy. That's how a lot of these receivers are being taught now.
Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. I know it's an emotional game, Charles. You can't do that.
And when you get into your film sessions and you argue your case with your coaches, that's exactly what they say at the end. You just can't do it. It costs your team.
So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 22-yard line. After the penalty, it's Fournette. And they'll get him down right about the 20. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, they didn't get a whole lot out of that one, but I think you've got to continue to try and run and try and keep a defense honest.
You mean, or else they'll just sit back, dare you to throw it on every down?
Yeah, you get your quarterback hit a lot that way, too.
Take him down and take us to the 2 minute warning. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We'll come back to Miami after this.
Competition comes up in so many different ways. And right now, this unit, their competition is who's going to get to the quarterback the most times. Had about 5 sacks last week. We just saw their first one of this game.
Now on fourth down, we've got a whistle here and a timeout as they stop it prior to what will be an important fourth down. Jason Sanders now for the Miami field goal. He's going to need a little mustard on this one. It'll be a 51-yard attempt. This is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. These kickers now, it used to be that a 50-plus yarder was cause for celebration, now seemingly automatic.
Yeah, isn't it funny? When we prepare for a game, when you look at the backgrounds of these kickers, it's interesting, isn't it, to find out they were All-State quarterbacks, receivers, defensive backs, All-State wrestlers, right? Baseball players. We're finding athletes all along, and now they're just specialists putting it through the posts.
Everyone's got four down. Check motion.
All right, now, lucky 56. All right, now, lucky 56.
On first down, Darnold. And he fires one that's intercepted. The linebackers, Stephon Anthony with a pick. And it's a terrific return here as he's going to have him set up with a first and goal right at about the 6-yard line. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal.
Three down.
Hurry up, here we go. Blue 90.
Hey, watch that. Check right 54. Do your job.
They'll give it to him up the middle. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the pickup. And that is going to set up third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
And on third and inches, we're going to get a whistle and a timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half.
Five down. Stand up in.
Gun!
Now this time he'll look to throw. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get three to end the first half. From the left hash, you'll have to cut this at a tight angle. Sanders' kick is good, and the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7. They got the interception, but very little movement after, and that forces him to settle for 3. And it does feel like settling when that happens.
It certainly does, but we got to give a lot of...
You want the third quarter already? No problem. Let's do it. So the two teams will head to the locker rooms here in Miami with the Dolphins on top. The Dolphins in front, and they'll be in possession of the football first as the second half gets started. Out comes the Dolphins now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking for some separation here as we begin the third quarter.
I like the way you term that, because now I think they go a little bit deeper into their playbook. They like what they did in the first half. That worked okay. But in order to get the separation that you just talked about, change things up a little bit. change your tendencies, try and hit them a little bit more with some things they didn't see in the first half.
Let's see if they do just that.
Green 39! Green 39!
Second half beginning with a run from Fournette. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 15 yards is the pickup there, and the drive starting very nicely. First down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's got his man on the crossing route. A really good pickup of 28 yards.
I know we just saw a nice throwing catch, but how about the big guys up front
buying that time?
Yeah, that's exactly what they did. They created time and allowed the space to happen, and it turned into a really nice play.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Hot.
They go play action here on first down. Going deep here for Parker. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Devontae Parker, his sixth touchdown of the season. And the Dolphins are able to grow their lead. And that time, he came out of the slot for that big play downfield for the score.
I think what we just saw there, partner, is what we call scheming a guy open. Put him in the slot, know that he has tremendous speed. What you're doing with your other receivers is likely running shorter routes to draw the attention closer to the line of scrimmage to give him a chance to get downfield and turn it into a one-on-one route, often against the safety. You like your odds when he's running against the safety. His speed usually wins, and it did on that play.
Here's the Jets offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Try and get things kick-started for them. And you know at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play a lot of the time.
How many plays do you script coming out of the second?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more.
The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Justin Houston in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year.
A shotgun snap for Darnold. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. We saw this a lot in the first half, and it continues. These receivers just not able to get much separation.
So that means they have to win the 50-50 balls. They've got to go up with the defender and find a way to start coming down with them.
And this time, contact and another incomplete pass. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Third and long, it's Darnold. Caught right side, Davis. And mark him down way up close to the 40 at the 39. 23 yards on the play. Defensively, they just lost him. He was waving his arm saying, I'm wide open. They found him.
Yeah, and it's so interesting about when a receiver starts to wave his arms, because some guys right off the line of scrimmage, they declare themselves open. You know, those guys throw the one arm up,
right.
Hit me right now. In this case, he was so wide open that he was frantically trying to get his attention to make sure he got the football. And then I'm sure his only thought when the ball was in the air, don't drop it. Had too much time to think.
This is Crowell. And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you, because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made. And that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game.
Here's Darnold. Going underneath for Crowell.
And he'll be stopped right at midfield. The Jet passing game in rhythm. They've got another first. Looked like a pretty good, safe play right there. No, he's had trouble with the interceptions in this game there. Hits his guy out in the flat.
Yeah, so many times we hear quarterbacks and offensive coordinators talk about in your progressions, you're either throwing the touchdown or you're throwing the check down. But earlier in the game, it was touchdown or interception. Now he got to the check down. A nice, safe throw and a good one.
And he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they've stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. Darnold. And an alley to run. Give him 12 yards there, and the Jets have a first.
Sometimes guys get locked into such a groove. What do we call it? The game slowing down. They see everything happening almost in slow motion. They see the lanes develop. I feel like he's right there.
Well, and you want this from your leader, right? With this deficit, this stage of the game, second half, no quitting him.
Zero.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Detroit! Detroit! Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
Ah! Darnold on first down. Stepping up. He's going to keep it. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be second and a couple.
Now, that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
Try the air now with Darnold. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Dolphins have got it. Holding on to the football, becoming a little bit of an issue. He had 2 fumbles last week, remember.
I played for a guy that used to talk all the time about creating turbulence in the pocket, making the quarterback jumpy, make him antsy, keep getting after him a little bit, and make sure he thinks about holding on to the ball because you're going after him.
Good starting field position for the Dolphins as they have it first and 10. Yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen there. That play got swallowed up.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. They'll throw. And bulldozing his way through. Oh, he's able to out-muscle it here as he pulls it in. And DP goes into Jets territory before being taken down.
That's a big-time pitch and catch right there. And, partner, I remember the days when quarterbacks would try this. They were holding their breath. But nowadays, they're counting on their receiver to be just a little bit better than the defensive back when it's one-on-one and the ball's in the air like that.
All right, here we go. 319! 319! Detroit! Detroit!
552. On first down, Drake. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. And what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Back now in Miami. hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on third down. The Dolphins on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is 3rd and 7.
Right there, 54, right there, 54, Mike. I'm coming after you. Six guys, check six.
Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Just keeping the play alive. He may try and run for this. Pretty solid gain of 7 yards that time as he scrambled, but now they face a fourth down.
I liked his effort there. He got it done on his own, but let's face it, he puts defenses in a really stressful spot when he takes off and runs because a lot of guys have coverage responsibilities.
Good job of rallying, though, because I thought when he first took off, he might pick up the first down. So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today. From the right hash at a bit of a tight angle. The kick by Sanders is good. And that will swell the lead to 16. So they settle for just the 3. But clearly right now anything helps trying to salt this one away in the fourth.
Without a doubt. Obviously a touchdown probably would have been the final nail to finish this thing off. But it's still 8 up time. Got points. So while it's not mission accomplished, it's darn close.
And New York set to take the field. And the turnover last time, that's sort of been symptomatic of their struggles here in this one.
Big word. I like it, though, because you're exactly right.
You like that, don't you?
All game long, they've struggled moving the ball, turning it over on the last possession. Is that word again, symptomatic?
Yeah.
I like that.
Your analysis, symptomatic of the success of this broadcast.
What I like is that you gave me the word, and I just kept using it.
On first down, it's Darnold. Under pressure, they got him again.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Got to imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18.
Here we go now. Lucky 56.
Now Darnold. Looking left side. He's got it complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. A good pickup there. 13 yards as they get closer for third down. They're given those short little routes, tackled him in bounds, too. They're just not going to get beat over the top.
Yeah, and if you can't really get downfield, take the short routes. But now you got to have guys who can actually break tackles and increase those gains.
The Jets on the move. Couple of big plays back-to-back. Now, correct me if I'm wrong. You know, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
This quarterback now 5 straight completions here in this second half. 1st and 10. The pitch to Corral. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be 2nd down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one by the line of scrimmage.
To throw is Darnold. Keeps himself upright, but he can't get away forever, and down he goes. That's number 4. Sack number 4. They had 4 last week, so he's been down on the ground a lot.
Partner, they say the eye in the sky does not lie. And that's indeed the case because they watched the game tape from the previous week, incorporated into their own defensive scheme, and continued to get after this quarterback.
And now this defense will be searching for sack number 5. The Jets on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 11. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. The Jets on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is 3rd and 11.
All right, here we go. 3-19. 3-19.
Darnold now to throw. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by the former first-rounder, Trey Wayne. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line. Well, that's 3 picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season, because here we are
season
in December.
Of giving.
Right, it is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Fournette, a first down carry. And he'll get it down inside the 20 to the 18-yard line. 9 yards is the pick up there, and they'll have a 2nd and 1. Able to stay in bounds, so the clock keeps rolling. This defense right now backed up in the red zone. Another touchdown, it's over. They've got to stand tall quickly.
Been in this spot before. Now there's a little bit of desperation creeping in, and all you're doing when you're talking to your defensive teammates is first guy there, hold him up. Second, third guy in, break it the football. Get it out. We've got to create a turnover because one more score, and this game's over.
2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Well, that was a unit that understood exactly where the first down marker was, handed it to their guy who could run it, created some space, and he got there.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10.
Set! 3-19! 3-19!
Here's a give to Fournette. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up 1st and goal. I guess he was saving his best for last, so to speak. Longest run of the day coming here in the 4th quarter right there.
And that type of run makes for a better night for him and his teammates, doesn't it? To be able to produce this late in the game can lead to some big smiles and satisfaction in the locker room after this one's over.
They'll try to punch it in with Fournette. Then he takes it into the end zone for the Dolphin touchdown. A great effort there with touchdown number 7 on the year. And the Dolphins use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for 6. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So out now come the Jets. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that, and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team, and we were losing late in a game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build
just
on.
Just something to build on, get it done, and maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
They keep it with Crowell on first. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up 2nd down. Bullshit.
copy. Diamonds in the chain, bust down wrists. And you ain't never seen no like this. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when the drop, whole game in the choke code.
I be out on a late night. I was in a play fight. See slime break night. This
break night.
My wristwatch is like a break light. And you can get it right on your gravesite. So tell me something I don't know. $50 pizza when I'm eating in Soho. I heard that you in love with the stuff in your hitting them. Hate me, they hate me. What should I do? Keep getting money. It's funny, I was just like you. Super Bowl Sunday. With the facts. Security guard told Kevin Hart to relax. Oh!
Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop, whole game in the chokehold. Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop, whole game in the chokehold.
I reinvented myself, they sorta hated it. I reinvented myself and upgraded it. Traded in the jewels, copped a couple new ones. Lost a couple friends and got a couple
new ones.
Upstairs and downstairs, the balcony. These ocean side views, the alchemy. Ain't nothing crazy like the city in the summertime. So when it's winter, I still be on my summer grind.
Handle your business, handle your business.
Lawyer and honor, don't break the bro codes. The more red rose, max with the rose gold. Whoever counted me out, they can't count.
Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop, whole game in the chokehold. Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop, whole game in the chokehold. They call a podcast Poppy. King goes, I see they tryna copy. Diamonds in the chain, bust down wrists. And you ain't never seen no like this. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when it drop, whole game in the chokehold. Chillax, 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 chillax. Chillax, 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 chillax. Chillax, 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 chillax. Chillax, 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 chillax.